Fabi, mi Frankie Boy, mis niños hermosos que quiero tanto. Y mi Adelilla, que se me olvida que también está acá en el familia. Estaba esperando yo hablarle a ella y aquí pues también lo puede oír. Son unos preciosos que me han ayudado y apoyado tanto. Y quería darles la noticia, chiquitas, que están sorprendidos porque no encontraron nada de cáncer, estaba limpia. Así que ellos mismos se sorprendieron mucho y que a lo mejor ya ni quimio me da. Y no me sacaron todo lo que me iban a sacar, por lo bien que me vieron. Así que imagínense el milagrote por todas sus oraciones de todos ustedes y de toda la familia. Dios es tan grande y me quiere tanto que me lo dijo desde el principio.
So nowadays, people always tend to forget what they have right in front of them. They don't seem to try and want to remember the people who will always be there for them. Nowadays, we are all victim to the fact that we rather do things that will basically give us pleasure instead of do the things that will benefit us for the future. We rather go be with other people who aren't going to be there in the long run instead of being there with the ones that actually want us to be there. And we just leave them off till the last minute and we put them till the end. You see, nowadays, we are all selfish people who feel like we're all high and mighty to try and make people feel less of themselves. We feel like we are too good to reply to people and leave them on read because we feel like we're too mature, when in reality, we're all just people with the biggest immaturity in the world. And we don't seem to want to humble up for anybody. And our heads are always in the clouds. Until there has to be a situation that puts our feet dirt deep on the ground and a problem that has to make us snap out of it. And sometimes it can even be too late. I was a victim of this situation. My head was in the clouds. I was being a terrible person with a lot of people. Until one day I came home and I see a worried face on my family. And it turns out they got a call from Mexico, and my grandma wasn't feeling so well. And she ended up going to the doctors, and in time, we found out that she had cancer. When you hear that word, the C word, the deadly word that honestly nobody in the world should know, you do know that you're getting to a new stage in life that you are most likely going to have a difficult time stepping out of. A word that can bring a lot of fear into the people's hearts, a lot of sadness, and a lot of challenges, and a lot of actual motivation to be brought into your life, because it is a word that will definitely take away your hope, your motivation, and also it takes away your right to live. And not literally taking away your rights to what you can do, but it takes away time, it takes away energy, because you always have to be going to check up and you have to be going through harsh treatments that will also weaken you, and you no longer are the strong person that you once were. Hearing this word can actually take people towards the darkest roads. It can honestly lead to other people getting into depression, and it is just one hell of a ride, and one ride that many don't make it out of. And for those who do, it is a walking miracle, and people who deserve all the respect in the world for having beaten cancer. Now, as you guys can tell, one of the people who definitely did make it out of this battle is my grandma. But before we get to that good end of the part, I'm gonna give you a quick background on her and how this whole situation played out. Maybe this video can spread awareness and motivate other people to keep fighting. So will stay along. Now, as for the person my grandma is, many of you clearly haven't met her. I could only give you guys my view on her. I could only give you guys a glimpse of what she is, but you guys will never be able to process how good of a person she is. But other than that, my grandma is definitely one of the people that you will never encounter in life ever again. You only encounter people like her once in your lifetime, and never again will you ever meet anyone like her. She is a person that is pure at heart. She is very humble. She is only the most, beautiful person. There is no words to explain how good of a person she is. She can honestly be said to be a walking angel, in my opinion, because she will never ever hold a frown on you. She will never make you feel like you're less of yourself. She will always put you before herself, because that's just how she is. Once she meets you, you become a part of her. Once you meet her, she will never forget you. Once you meet her, she will pray for you. She's just a person that has always been strong at heart. She has never seen life in a negative way. She has always been very positive. She always finds the good things and the bad things as well. And she's a person who is super strong, stronger than most of us, and who can put up with way more than what we can. So, with that being said, all of us have challenges, but the strongest people are the ones who get the strongest challenges. So my grandma has been faced with a hard challenge this past year, being cancer. We all knew her as a healthy young lady who honestly we didn't expect to ever have this type of problem. We were shocked actually when we heard that she had cancer. We always looked at her and she was always walking around everywhere. She was cooking, she was cleaning, she was doing things for all of us, and never once did she take a rest. She was always doing something. Literally, she's one of those people that you will never see not being active. And it's kind of shocking to hear that one day she couldn't walk up the stairs because she couldn't catch her breath. And it was very difficult to hear that she had cancer, because everybody knew her for the strong, healthy lady she was, and it just all came to shock on us that she is going through this. Well, was. But something that she shouldn't honestly deserve. So once my grandma was diagnosed with cancer, we were faced with such frustration. Most of the time, most of us that were her family had blank stares on our faces, hours and hours crying, hours and hours staring into a blank wall with nothing on it, just thinking of what just hit us, how hard life came down crashing on us. Literally all we felt was lost hope. All we felt is, how much time do we have left with her? We were so negative, to the point where we thought, wow, this might really be the end of something very valuable in our life, something that words can no ever explain. A big part of my heart, and I'm pretty sure for other of my family members, a big part of their heart was ripped out. And we have never felt so much faith lost in that moment when we found out that she actually was in risk of even losing her life, because this sickness, as you all know, is death-defying. Sometimes we have people who don't make it out. Sometimes people don't want to fight because of the hard process, and it's not that they're not strong, they just know that sometimes this fight can really get to a point where you might not even make it. So millions and millions of people a year die to this sickness. Many people are still struggling, fighting. Years and years on, they are fighting for this sickness to end. And many people are barely finding out that they do have it year and year round. Many people get diagnosed with this sickness. And
out of all those millions of people, one of them was my grandma. And there's many people out there who are strong and make it out of this. Many people who try to make it out of this, and unfortunately, sadly, some people don't make it. And I surely hope that God has them in a better place. And I surely do wish that they at least left happy from this world. But the point is, for those who fight, there should be much respect for them, even the ones who didn't, because they face something that no one should ever face. Something that they face that many of us wouldn't be able to handle, including myself. If I were to hear that I had the sickness, I would be so negative. I wouldn't find any positivity in life anymore, and I would honestly feel like I am going to leave very soon. But that's not what happened with my grandma. She was one of those people who did fight. She was one of those people who found a good thing to everything. She literally was the one who snapped us all out of it, and she was the one with the sickness. She told us, "I'm going to be fine, guys." And even though there was times that she would also cry and feel scared, that didn't mean she lost hope. She would always tell us, "Guys, as long as you have faith and as long as you don't lose hope, all of us will come out on top in the end, and including myself, there was going to be a way that I am going to get better." It all started in Mexico, where I was born. She lost her breath. She was diagnosed with cancer. She had to literally go to the hospital many times, sometimes to not even get treated. Sometimes they would leave her in the waiting room, waiting hours and hours just to get a bed because there wouldn't be any beds. Sometimes, literally, she would go waiting for hours for them to not even do anything and send them back home. Hours wasted for nothing. Sometimes she wouldn't even get the treatments. Sometimes they would send my grandparents back home and tell them, "Oh, come back in a week for the next treatment, come back in 2 weeks, or hey, maybe we should wait it out and see what happens." Like, all of this time passed, and so much frustration. Literally, all that time wasted, where it was a lost opportunity to be able to do something to help her with this sickness. And as much as I love Mexico, and as much as I want to talk good about them, the hospitals over there were nothing compared to the ones here in the United States. So it got to a point where this whole summer, we just saw one of the biggest people who my family loved starting to get drained of her life. She was literally getting weaker and weaker by the day, to the point where a lot of us were losing faith and saying, "What? How much time are we gonna have with her?" We literally thought the worst. And yet, though she kept getting weaker and she was able to walk up the stairs less and less each day, my grandma was the only one who knew she would get better. Even us, who she needed to hear better things from and see that they were happy and get good vibes off of, were the ones who ended up losing hope. So she had to basically at one point give herself hope and pray that she didn't want to leave this world, because she knew how much we needed her. She knew that we weren't ready to lose someone that precious to us. And honestly, we will never ever be ready to lose someone like her, because no one will ever want to lose someone that we treasure that much the way we treasure her. So it got to the biggest part of where it's too soon. As I said, she was always an energetic lady who was very strong, so having this happen to her was not acceptable for us. So once she got us and sat us down and snapped all of us out of it this summer, when we were all there in Mexico, she told us, "If you guys don't keep faith and hope, everything is lost. You guys have to keep God, pray to him every single day and tell him, please leave her here." We literally prayed for her after mass. We would have her name announced and her situation happening so people can pray for her. Literally on Facebook, there's a page, a little group, where they send out messages to millions of people to pray for special causes like these, for hard situations that people go through. And she was one of the people who got a big shout out to a lot of people. Thousands and thousands of people literally prayed for her. You have no idea how many people actually prayed for her. So this whole process, we actually ended up getting a lot of faith and hope. We waited it out, but sadly to say, the hospitals over there did nothing. So once my family, my mom, and my sisters had to come back from Mexico, we left being scared of what would happen next, because nothing was getting done over there. So while we were already over here, we ended up having a call with my grandparents, and they ended up coming, ended up making the decision, which was a hard one for them, because we didn't know what would happen. They ended up deciding to come over here and get all the treatments they needed and end up continuing the fight over here in the United States, which was honestly the best decision they could have ever made, because that was actually her salvation. And yes, there were times where she would let a few tears down her face because she knew how hard this fight was, and because she was worried of what might happen, she did cry because she wasn't ready to leave us. But let me tell you guys something that really did happen, something that she witnessed, something that literally many of you won't believe, because there's many people who are too stubborn out there to believe. But there was one day in specific where she was on a bed in the hospital, and for like a whole week, one of those nights, she was on her phone, and she was using an app called WhatsApp. Many of you know that app because it's a texting app where people can contact each other. And out of nowhere, my grandma gets this text message that basically, it's from this lady in Mexico, and the message basically said, in Spanish, I'm gonna translate it into English, but it was in Spanish, and it said, "My little girl, you will be perfectly fine. I know what you're going through, and in the end, you are going to make it out of this. I'm going to make sure that you are going to be perfectly fine. Just keep on fighting." So afterwards, she clicks off of the message and she gets off of that chat, and actually she goes back because she loved that message very much, that it made her cry. And when my mom and me got to the hospital, or actually my aunt got back to the hospital, my grandma wanted to show her, and she was replying to the girl, telling her how beautiful that message was and how it made her cry. And once she tried getting that message and tried to show my aunt, the message was gone. So my grandma tried asking the girl what she sent, and it turned out that the girl had sent her something else that was completely off topic, that wasn't even related to what she was going through. And she had actually only sent a picture of a prayer to make towards God. And my grandma felt the biggest goosebumps because it ended up being a message from God himself. And even though I wasn't there to see it, I believe her, because she's not crazy, guys. Like, she knows what she saw. And it was literally a message directly received from God, and she couldn't find it anymore. But the fact that it said, my little girl, like, you're going to be fine, was shocking. And believe it or not, guys, that's how you know that message was actually true. She wasn't lying to us, because in the end, she did make it out of that fight. But going back to the story, there was still times, even though after we got that message, we would still be scared, because there'd be times that the doctors would basically find some weird things in her body after she was scanned and all that, and it would kind of leave us worried. But my grandma would always remind us, remember the message that it got, remember. My mom was also one of the people keeping everyone positive. I had to keep some people positive, and believe it or not, guys, I had to be strong for my grandma and fake my smile most of the time. And I had to honestly, even though I lost hope, I had to act like I didn't for her, just to make her smile and just to give her strength, because she needed pure positive vibes. So I had to basically be one of the people giving everyone positivity, telling them everything's gonna be okay, she's gonna make it out of this. And even though at times I would honestly feel like I was just lying to them, I ended up telling myself, hey, where's your faith? Believe in God. And I prayed. And then at one point, I did believe she would make it out of this, and she did. Literally, guys, it was at a point where she had 1,007% of blood in her body. Once you hear those numbers, anyone is bound to be negative and say, damn, this might be a situation in which you might not make it out of. But during this whole process, all these chemos and all this treatment, that took away the pain from her body but also weakened her at the same time. Ended up making her percentage go all the way down, believe it or not, guys, to 8%. A big decline in what started as 1,007 to 8. But the sad thing in this moment was that 8% was very strong. Literally, that 8% wanted to fight back, to go back to where it all started, to basically ending her. That 8% wanted to go hard back in to basically destroy what had been getting destroyed at the start. So they had to go harder with a smart type of chemotherapy to basically fight off this cancer. So they went through with it, and over time, it went down to the final operation, the operation that would end it all. This operation was also death-defying. This operation was literally a risk for her life because they literally cut through the middle of her stomach to open up. And it was a big risk because if anything went wrong, it would mean her life on the line. Now, with that being said, many of us are happy. Many of us love you, Grandma. Many of us adore you. We literally look up to you very much, and you are one of those people who we cannot lose. We will never, ever be ready to lose you. And that day, I hope, doesn't come for so many years, because I need you here. I need you in my life, because you are one of the biggest inspirations. You're one of the biggest things that keep me going in this life. You're one of the only reasons why I'm fighting, making this video. You're one of the only reasons why I'm even doing YouTube, because I want to eventually get somewhere to buy you something, to basically give you guys a house so I can tell you to live in that house for. You're the only reason why I'm still in school. You're literally the only reason why I want to be humble and have no drama with anyone anymore. You literally changed me as a person. I used to have so much drama and be, I was such a terrible person, to a point where you literally made me want to change who I am and become a better person, because I want to make you proud, because I'm already proud of the person you are. Always there for me, always trying to cook for me. Even when you had cancer and you were weak, you asked me if I wanted anything to eat. You would go downstairs even though you didn't have the energy, just to clean up for me. Just you literally would tell me if I needed help cleaning my own room, which I'm already old enough to do on my own. And you are literally washing all of our clothes, even though we are all old enough to do it ourselves. Never once did you leave me in the dark when we should have been making sure you were okay. You were actually there worrying about us when you didn't even worry about yourself. So with this being said, I congratulate you very much for making it through this whole fight. And there is no words to ever explain how happy I am you're still here and how much I very deeply love you. But all I could show is that many people love you. So let's actually show you a few messages that people took their time out of their day to send to you, to show that love that we have for you. These next clips are definitely people who have gotten to meet you and gotten close to you and gotten to meet you. People who are your family. People who have truly had an actual conversation with you and have literally, like, no way to explain in words how much they love you. These next few messages are going to be short due to the time that they did have for this, but if we had the words and the time, we would literally keep talking and talking forever, because we want to show you how much we love you. But in the short amount we have, here's a few messages for you. I hope you do like them. These next few messages are from people who literally were close to you and who you hold dearly in your hearts.
Me pide mi nieto Gonzalo. Ay, qué bárbaro, un pelado con un nombre muy bonito. Me dice que hable sobre mi esposa, su abuelita. Y hay muchas cosas que tendría que decir, muchas, especialmente que la quiero mucho y que, haciendo un recuento en estos últimos tiempos que hemos pasado muy difíciles toda la familia, al pensar que el riesgo que existiera perder a esta persona de la que hablamos, mi esposa Angelina, y que bendito sea Dios, y por intermediación de la familia que tenemos aquí en Estados Unidos, en especial de mi hija Adela, de mi hija Adelita, y mi chaparrita chula, que gracias a ella tuvimos la posibilidad de que fuera atendida su mamá aquí en Estados Unidos, y que los resultados han sido muy satisfactorios. Nos quedamos asustados, con miedo, porque estamos hablando de una enfermedad muy, muy, muy peligrosa, muy difícil, y siempre estaremos con ese miedo de que apareció en alguien de nosotros, pero los resultados, como decía, son satisfactorios. Parece ser que todo va bien, que tenemos ahorita casi sin nada de enfermedad a mi esposa, y aunque todavía no termine el tratamiento, estamos todos muy confiados, agarrados de la mano de Dios y de mi mamita virgen, como siempre digo, porque han sido claves desde luego para que mi esposa y todos nos sintamos que estamos cobijados, protegidos con el manto de ella, desde luego con la mano de Dios tocando a mi esposa y con esta bendición. Y muy agradecidos con la familia, con todos, como decía, con mi hija Adelita y su familia de aquí, Pedro, su esposo, mis nietos, toda mi familia, la familia de mi esposa, que se han unido en oración, en cadena, muchísimos amigos que contamos también con sus oraciones. Así que le digo a mi esposa que bendito sea Dios, que estás aquí con nosotros, que te quiero mucho.
Hola, mamita. Quiero que sepas que sé que hoy tengo que compartir mi tiempo con otras personas, si no, esto podría ser larguísimo para mí, porque hay muchas cosas que yo te quisiera decir. Sabes que tú eres algo grande en mi vida, que eres de lo más importante de mi vida, que te amo con todo mi corazón. Soy muy orgullosa, eres un ejemplo para mí, eres una maestra. Quiero decirte que desde que yo nací en una cuna bendecida. Diosito me mandó a la mejor pancita del mundo, a la mejor matriz, a la mejor cuna. Y de ahí, tú escogiste a la mejor pareja para formar la mejor familia. Le diste a unos hermanos maravillosos. Y de ahí unos abuelitos, unas tías, nos rodearon de pura familia hermosa, amistades bonitas. Y pues mi vida, yo tengo puros recuerdos bonitos. Eres una mamá maravillosa, la mejor mujer, la mejor mamá. Te agradezco por todo eso, mami. Y más que tú, ser la mejor mujer del mundo y la mejor mamá, Diosito fue el que hizo todo esto. Quedaste limpia, mami. Gracias, Jesús. Te amo. Te amo, mami.
Mamita, hola, mi chiquita. Tú sabes que Diosito nos puso una prueba muy difícil para empezar contigo. Yo en otros momentos hubiera pensado que jamás iba a superar algo así. De solo pensarlo me ponía a llorar. ¿Te acuerdas? Te admiro mucho porque tú lo lograste, porque nos enseñaste, como siempre, a que hay que tener fortaleza y sobre todo mucha fe. Y Diosito nos hizo el milagro. Te quiero mucho, mami, y te admiro mucho. Significas mucho para mí, lo sabes. Gracias.
Hola, mamá. Pues más que nada quería decirte que tal vez te olvides de mí, tal vez me olvide de ti, pero una vez aprendí que no se debe mentir. Si estoy llorando, no es que me extrañe el corazón, es que a tu lado yo aprendí el dolor. No podrás olvidar que te amé, como yo nunca imaginé. ¿Eh? Ah, es una canción de Cristian Castro. Ah, no, perdón. No, prácticamente esto no le das mucho caso, pero ya en serio, estamos muy felices cuando nos enteramos de la noticia. De la hermosa noticia del milagro, de que estabas bien. Fue un momento de sacar todo lo que traíamos, tensiones, muchas cosas, aunque teníamos fe y sabíamos que todo iba a salir bien, escuchar esa noticia, pues fue como sacar todo de una manera muy alegre, pero sí un desahogo por todo lo que traíamos ya por dentro, yo creo, de varios meses. Y estamos muy felices de que, gracias a Dios primeramente, y en segundo que eres muy positiva y que eso también ayuda siempre, siempre a que la salud se recupere. Entonces estamos, para empezar, pues, que me permitiera ser parte de tu vida, ser parte de tu familia, y es el mayor milagro que puedo yo tener, que seas mi mamá. No hay mejor regalo que seas parte de mi familia y que yo sea tu hijo. Y es, digamos, que lo mejor, y es algo que puede uno incluso, pues, orgullosamente decirlo, que me tocó que fuera mi mamá. Te quiero mucho y quiero muchos años contigo, muchos, muchos años. Te quiero mucho y eres la mejor.
Angie, tú ya sabes, yo creo que esperábamos esto, pero en el momento que ya se confirmó el milagro grande que hizo nuestro Señor, no te imaginas cómo nos pusimos todas. Cuando le hablamos a Vivian, otra vez a llorar, estaba ahí con su suegra, y ellas también, de la emoción, a llorar. Que Diosito es tan maravilloso, y pues nos sorprende sabiendo que Él es lo máximo, pero cada que hace el milagro nos llena de emoción. Gloria a Dios. Cuídateme mucho, mi chiquita. Dios te bendiga.
Más que nada, quiero agradecerle a nuestro Señor por ese gran milagro que nos hizo. Y Angie, estamos de lo más encantados, fascinados de la maravilla que hizo en ti. Y en nosotros igual, porque todos estamos encantados, y miles de gentes que están visitando y encantados. Y pues, ¿qué más te puedo decir? Que estamos encantados. Y que sigas igual. Luego nos vemos.
Te queremos mucho,
estamos
extrañamos.
Muy contentos con
el milagro que nos hizo. Ya fuimos a dar gracias a Dios por el milagro que nos hizo. Y esperamos verte pronto.
¿Cómo estás? Espero que estés bien.
Quiero dar testimonio sobre mi hermanita Angelina. No sabría cómo empezar y cómo explicar algo tan grandioso que Dios nos ha regalado, el milagro de mi hermana y el milagro de tener a toda la familia reunida y más cerca cada una y cada uno de nosotros. Hemos testimoniado tantos milagros en la familia, todo esto a través del sacrificio de nuestra hermana, que tuvo que pasar por esta situación tan difícil, pero que para nosotros hemos recibido tantas bendiciones, y aparte un milagro grande que solamente Él sabe por qué nos lo regaló. Es tan bonito haber tenido a mi hermana conmigo por algún tiempo. La he disfrutado, mi hijo y yo la hemos disfrutado, y claro, muchos de la familia también, porque nos da alegría, nos da positividad, siempre con esa alegría que nos comprueba que confiar en Dios es lo más bonito. Esperar en lo que Él quiera de nosotros, no lo que uno quiera, sino lo que Él quiera de nosotros. Y eso me sirvió al estar siempre con mi hermana Angelina. Que Dios se lo pague y que bendiga a su familia y que nos ayude a todos. Gracias.
Bueno, Angie, antes que nada, vamos a alabar y adorar a nuestro Señor por el milagro tan grande que obró en ti. Y sí, fue gracias a tu muy grande fe que tuviste en Él y la confianza. Siempre dijiste que tus doctores no iban a ser ellos los que te iban a ni operar, ni atender, ni nada, que siempre iba a ser Jesús. Nuestro Rey, nuestro hermoso Diosito hermoso, fue el que te curó y el que sigue curándote. Pero más que nada, lo que se necesita es la fe, y la tuviste, y la tuviste solo en Él. Y por obrar así, porque Dios le gusta que tengamos confianza en Él. Y tú la tienes. Eso le agrada mucho a mi Jesús. Demasiado. Por eso hoy le damos gracias a mi Rey hermoso por lo que hizo. De curarte. Y de siempre estar a tu lado. Él y su Santísima Madre nunca te dejaron, ni tú los dejabas a ellos. Eso es lo más hermoso. Y también por eso te quiero decir que estoy muy, muy orgullosa de ti, por tu hermosa y grande fe que tienes. Te quiero mucho, mija, y le damos gracias a Dios por obrar de ese milagro tan grande en ti. I love you.
Hola, Angie. Estoy encantada, encantada. Yo ya sabía, nuestro Señor ya te lo había dicho desde el principio, pero de todos modos nunca creí que tan pronto, yo no sabía cuándo iba a ser su maravilla, pero yo estoy fascinada. Todo el mundo está encantado, todo el mundo te manda a saludar, están encantados con las maravillas que hace nuestro Señor. Todo el mundo está encantado, mi familia, Javier, mis hijos. Así que gloria a Dios y te esperamos pronto. Te veo pronto allá. Primero Dios.
Más tiempo para que conozca más bien a sus nietos y a mí. I love you with all my heart, even though yo soy su mejor y favorito yerno. Alright, but I do love you and you scared the shit out of us, so love you, ma, and thank you for letting me have your daughter. All the grand, and all your grandchildren that you have. Bye.
Hola, hola Gigi, buenas noches. Estoy muy contento por la noticia y queremos expresarle que la queremos mucho y le mandamos muchos abrazos y besos. Y ya esperamos verla pronto por acá. La quiero mucho, Gigi.
Tía chula, primero que nada quiero agradecerle a Diosito por hacernos el milagro tan grande de sanarte y a mi Madre Santísima, la Virgencita, por interceder con Diosito para que nos lo concediera. También, tía, quiero decirte que te quiero muchísimo y que estoy muy orgullosa de ti y del gran ejemplo de fe y fortaleza que nos has dado a todos para aguantar todo lo que tuviste que pasar. Solamente una persona como tú, con ese carácter tan bonito que tienes y positivo, podía haberlo hecho. Por eso todos te queremos tanto y estamos tan orgullosos de ti. Que Dios te siga bendiciendo a ti y a toda tu familia. Te queremos muchísimo.
Tía Angie, antes que nada quería decirte que nos dio muchísimo gusto cuando supimos que ya estabas de cáncer. Nos dio muchísimo gusto a toda la familia. También quería decirte que nos dejaste una enseñanza muy grande de tu fe en Dios y tu confianza en Dios. De la actitud tan bonita que tuviste en todo el proceso, de que a pesar de que estabas malita tú, seguías preocupándote por todos y de que todos estuvieran contentos y tranquilos. Te quiero mucho, que Diosito te siga bendiciendo, tía. Te queremos muchísimo todos, mis niños también, mi esposo. Te queremos mucho, tía. Que Diosito te bendiga.
Hola, tía Angie. I love you so much. Le doy tantas gracias a Diosito que te dejó con nosotros, que estás con nosotros. Y espero muy pronto verte. Los chaparritos te mandan muchos besos y abrazos y que ya te extrañan. Yo también te extraño muchísimo y ya te queremos acá, tía. Diles que ya es tiempo. Love you. Besos.
Hola, tía.
Angelina, mucho gusto que estés bien y que me da mucho gusto que haya salido todo bien y pues échale ganas, tía, aquí. Saludos de parte mía y de todos y que estés bien. Estoy muy contento porque estés bien y echándole ganas y otra lección más de fe. Qué bueno que estés bien. Saludos, tía.
Hola, tía. Me da mucho gusto que ya estés bien. Mejor. Te esperamos acá en Lagos. Te quiero mucho, tía. Saludos.
Hola, Angelina. Veo con mucho gusto y una gran satisfacción tu recuperación. De vuelta con nosotros. Qué bueno. Felicidades. Sí, a disfrutar la familia, a disfrutar la casa. Y adelante, siempre adelante. Un gran like.
Hola, buenas tardes, señora Angelina. Nada más le quería decir que me da tanto, tanto gusto de que todo haya salido bien, que gracias a Dios todo le salió bien. Ojalá y que Dios la siga bendiciendo y que siempre siga adelante con esa nueva vida que Dios le ha regalado hoy en estos días. La felicito, mil felicitaciones. Y también le doy gracias a Dios por su hija, por su esposo, que cómo la han cuidado, que cómo la han mimado, gracias. Y gracias también le doy por querer a mi hijo, por aceptarlo así como es, pero gracias por quererlo tanto, porque yo sé que así como yo quiero a su hija, usted también quiere al mío. Y Dios le ha dejado, la ha dejado más tiempo para que usted siga viendo todas las maravillas que el Señor hace. Gracias le doy a Dios por su vida y por su recuperación. Y felicidades a usted y a su esposo. Y no se olvide que siempre tiene un lugar en mi corazón, que siempre seguirá en mis oraciones y que siempre tendrá ese lugar en mi corazón y en mi casa. Gracias por ser la mamá de mi nuera. Gracias y no se olvide que la quiero mucho. Dios me la siga bendiciendo siempre, siempre, siempre.
Hola, señora Angelina, soy la mamá de Esmeralda. Espero se encuentre bien. Me da gusto que haya salido ya bien de toda su enfermedad. Y quiero felicitarla por ser una mujer fuerte, valiente y hermosa. La quiero mucho y pronto la volveré a ver.
Hi, so first of all, I want to say that I love you and that you're truly the most beautiful and strongest person that I have ever met. Knowing that you went from a high percentage of cancer to absolutely no trace of it in your system is honestly a blessing. You never failed to amaze me and how positive you were throughout this whole journey. There was times that I would go and visit you and the first thing I would see when I entered the room was this big beautiful smile of yours, and even though I knew you were in pain, you always kept that smile on your face and you always saw the beauty in things and the beauty in life. I want to thank each and every member of your family for always being there and supporting you and helping you stay strong throughout this whole journey. But most importantly, I want to thank God for allowing you to be here with us. And thank you very much for being part of my family. I love you so much.
Hi, my name is Sarah. As my sister, I just wanted to tell you that I'm happy that you have beaten cancer and you are a strong, brave woman. And I hope you stay strong. And I'll send you lots of love. Bye.
Abuelita, I wanted to tell you que most importantly, I love you and that congratulations that you beat cancer, that you're a cancer fighter and survivor, and that I'm so happy that we got to experience you coming here with us and that you don't have cancer anymore because you're healthy and you're good, and most importantly, you're gonna be with us for a very long time. And gracias, Diosito, because he helped you and because he helped all of us, and because even though there were like sometimes it was like it seemed like nothing was happening, everything was good, and I'm happy that everything is going good and that I love you, and I hope that you don't have to leave for a very long time. Abuelita, you're very strong a person because you had cancer and you fought it very well because you fought the pain when it was really hard and you lost all your hair and everything. And you came over here just so you could fight your cancer, and I really love you for it, for everything that you've done, because you've tried really hard, and we really love you. We really hope that you stay really healthy so you can live on more and more. So, and I really love you, and I hope you could stay a little bit longer, even though your cancer is already gone. And you're really strong, and I love you a lot.
Hi, abuelita, it's Pedrin. I'm happy that you beat cancer, and I hope that you stay here longer, and that I hope one day that you will live here, maybe next door, so then we can have fun and do stuff together. I love you.
I like that abuelita has no more cancer, and that she can still be with us, and she can still play with us even though she could be on the bed, and she could be telling us jokes, and she could, and I love her, and then I also like that she gives us stuff even though sometimes we're not that nice to her. I love you, abuelita.
Hola Gigi, te quiero mucho, mucho, mucho. Cuando oí el audio de que te curaste, me alegré mucho y demasiado. Siempre tuve fe en que te ibas a curar, aunque a veces tuve miedo, pero siempre creí que te ibas a curar. Y te quiero mucho, ya te quiero volver a ver. Y siempre le anduve pidiendo a Diosito que te curaras. Te quiero mucho, mucho, mucho. Ya quiero verte otra vez y me da mucho gusto de que ya te hayas curado. Y te quiero mucho, mucho. Ya te quiero volver a ver. Te envío muchos saludos. Te quiero.
Hola, Gigi, te quiero mucho. Ya te quiero ver. Qué bueno que ya te curaste. Y qué bueno que te faltan pocas cosas y ya para ya rápido vernos. Te mando abrazos y besos.
Hola tía, ¿cómo estás? Espero que estés muy bien. Te quiero mucho y ya te extrañamos. Hola tía, ¿cómo estás? Ya te extrañamos mucho.
Now, as you saw right there, those were all the people who you have met, who are very close to you. There's many more people out there who are very close to you. Sadly, we didn't have enough time to get those videos from those other people, but we know they do send their messages and their congratulations to you. But there's many more people out there than what you just saw that love you and are very happy you're still here and who never want to lose you. If you ever literally feel, Grandma, that you are not special, I want you to know that you are. I want you to know from this day forward, and for the rest of your life, and I hope I've made you feel this all the time, that I really do love you. I never get bored of you. I never want to be away from you. I'm always excited to see you when I come from school. Even though I'm out a lot, I do always have you in my mind. I promise you, I never forget about you. And I promise you, because you always tell me in Spanish as a joke that we get bored of that little old lady, because that's what you say. But believe it or not, I don't like yourself calling you old lady. I always like to see you as a young lady, and I literally never get bored of you. So many of us people love you to death. But now these next few clips are from people that you have met but haven't gotten the time to meet even more deeper, who already tell me that you're the sweetest person out there, who tell me as well that they love the way you are, that they love how humble you are and how you'll always have that beautiful smile on your face. And even though some of these people you haven't even met or seen in your life, they wanted you to make it out of this fight. They literally sent out their prayers. They literally sent out their best regards for you. And they also, even though they didn't know you, and some did know you but not good enough, they took their time out of their day to send you these videos. And I hope you also enjoy them. And make sure you do know as well by these clips that you are loved even by people who don't know you. That's how special you are, Grandma. And as I said, we won't ever be able to explain it, but maybe these videos will give you at least 1/4 of how much you are and how much you mean to us. So enjoy these videos as well.
Hi, my name is Andrew. I just want to congratulate you, Gonzalez's grandmother, on how you beat cancer, because it's amazing. A lot of people go through cancer and not get through it, but you are a true champion. You got through it. And like this weight here, which is 45 pounds, is heavy. That increases my strength physically, but mentally, I'll never have the strength you have. And I applaud you for that. That's amazing.
What's up, guys? I just wanted to go ahead and show you the art piece I just got done making. It actually came out really good. I'm just kidding. I just wanted to go ahead and congratulate Gonzalo's grandma. She just won one of the toughest battles out there, which was the battle towards cancer. And I'm really, really happy for that. Extremely happy for that, actually. I'm sure a lot of us have been praying for it. And yeah, well, have a good one, guys.
Señora Angelina, saludos y felicidades por las buenas noticias. Sé que difícil fueron los pasados meses para usted y para su familia. Mi abuela también pasó por el cáncer y como usted fue muy valiente y le echó todas las ganas para seguir adelante. Y quiero que sepa usted que es muy bendecida. No todos derrotan el cáncer, no es algo fácil. Es algo muy, muy grande. Y le deseo lo mejor, que se cuide, descanse y que le sigan lloviendo las bendiciones.
Hi, my name is Oscar. I'm one of Gonza's friends, and I'm honestly really, really happy that you were able to beat cancer. And I'm glad that you're healthy now and everything's going well for you. Remember to always thank God and be positive and stay strong with yourself.
Okay.
Hola, me llamo Eileen.
Me llamo Emmanuel.
Y le queremos decir que estamos muy contentos porque está bien de su salud. Eres una mujer muy fuerte y estamos muy contentos y que Dios les dé muchos años más. Yeah, estamos muy felices.
Congrats on beating cancer. Not a lot of people could have done it, but you did, which shows a lot about you. And you didn't give in, you just kept fighting. And have a nice day.
You are so strong and brave, and I'm so thankful that you got through cancer. It's just such a mess, and I'm so sorry that you had to go through that, but good job for getting out of it.
First and foremost, I just wanted to say congrats. I'm sure beating cancer was nothing easy, but you did it. That shows how strong you are. Much love from me to you.
Que me vaya a trabajar, solo le quiero decir muchas felicidades por haber vencido el cáncer. Ya sé que el proceso no es nada fácil, ni tampoco algo que brinda alegría a la familia.
Hey, Gonzalo's grandmother, I just want to congratulate you on beating cancer. I'm so happy for you. I'm proud of you, what journey you went through and how everything went so far and how God was on your side and how he made you a miracle. And I'm pretty sure you're a strong woman. I've never met you before, but I'm happy for you. My mom had skin cancer, so I know what it's like. And I've had family members that had cancer and unfortunately they didn't make it, but it's okay. It's all about living your life and continuing your journey.
Hey guys, it's Angel. I just want to say congratulations to Gonzalo's grandma for beating cancer. You know, it really makes you think how strong God is and how his influence and how prayers can really help someone. I actually did pray every night for Gonzalo's grandma to be well, and thank God that they didn't find any cancer cells. So it just really, I'm just really happy for her. You know, she is the sweetest woman. You know, I always visit Gonzalo's house and she always gives me like the warmest welcome, leaves a smile on my face. She's just adorable to me. You know, it just makes you really think how we're so prone to having cancer, and like it's just really life threatening. So I think this was a cool thing. You know, it was a learning experience for me, and you know, I think good for Gonzalo's grandma for being cancer.
Hey, Gonzalo,
Gonzalo's grandma. Congratulations on beating cancer.
Señora Angelina, quiero decirte felicidad por lo que tú has logrado, lo que tú has hecho es muy grande, pero muy grande. Aquí estamos nosotros peleando contigo a todo dar. Sigue para arriba y para adelante, ya tú sabes, dale.
Hola, soy Omar, la quiero felicitar por su gran milagro que le pasó cuando tuvo cirugía, que los doctores le dijeron que ya no tenía cáncer y que, ya no tenía, que a lo mejor ya no tenía que hacer chemotherapy. Esto pasó por que Dios le dio la bendición de que ya no tenía, que ya no tenía cáncer. Quiero felicitarla y quiero que en mi parte yo creo que usted es una persona muy fuerte, porque casi las personas que tienen cáncer tienen que estar luchando contra el cáncer, y usted no nomás luchó contra el cáncer, usted hizo un milagro que es ya no tener cáncer. La quiero felicitar y por mi parte que Dios la cuide, que Dios esté con usted siempre, y a ver si uno de estos días la veo.
Hi, Gonzalo's grandmother. My name is Abraham, or as Gonzalo knows me as Scribbles. Just wanted to say congratulations on beating cancer. You're a very strong woman. There's not many people like you on this planet who was able to fight through, fight cancer, take it head on, and was able to beat it. Just saying that even though I've never met you, I'm saying I'm proud to hear that you beat cancer. And I know Gonzalo was very sad about when he heard you had cancer, but now seeing Gonzalo happy now is truly the best. Seeing that my friend is happy again, and just want to say congratulations once again for beating cancer. Never change who you are. You're a very special woman. Congratulations.
Okay, hello Gonzalo's grandma. I know we haven't probably met, but my name's Eduardo.
I'm Enrique.
And we overheard the good news that you overcame cancer. And we were just ecstatic to know that you've been blessed to live another day. And we're really good friends with your grandson, and we haven't properly met, but I know that just from your grandson, I can tell that you're such an amazing woman.
And that it's a miracle, you know, that to know that there's surprises that can actually happen, you know, not just to one person, but to everybody. And it's a gift from God that not everybody gets.
And we are so thankful that you were able to live another day, and we're so excited that we're probably going to meet you one day, and we just know that you're going to do the best in life, and congratulations again.
This video is for Gonzalo's grandmother. I just want to congratulate her on beating cancer, and I wish her the best.
Hey, I just want to say congrats on beating cancer. It's really amazing. You're living proof of what the power of prayer can do. You're proof that God is good. You're proof that God exists. You're a walking miracle. It's so beautiful. And you're such a beautiful person, and you're so sweet, and everybody loves you. And you really, really, really do deserve to live on. So congratulations.
Te quiero mucho, Abuelita.
Thank you. I love you too.
Mucho. I'm very happy que estén aquí con nosotros.
Now that all these videos have been done, Grandma, I tried to make this video serious as possible. I'm a guy who jokes around and doesn't take much serious because I love making life fun. But I tried to make this video as heart filling for you as possible, to make sure you feel the emotion in our voices, to make sure you know how much I love you. And I just hope this video made you happy and made you realize that we really need you in this world, and to keep fighting and never give up, because you have definitely shown us the biggest value in life is never to give up. And Grandma, I truly, truly, really love you. And I literally never want to lose you. And I literally congratulate you beyond any words to explain for having beaten this. Because I know I wouldn't have been able to beat something like this. And as I said in the beginning, These challenges happen to the best of us, and you're one of those best people. And you, I just love you, Grandma. I can't explain it, but I hope you enjoyed this video. This was specifically for you. I love you. We all do. We all truly do love you.
Hi, everybody. This is my baby, my sweetie, my first grandson, the most beautiful one.
¿Tienes algo que decir for the subscribers?
¿Cómo?
You have something to say for the subscribers?
¿Cómo?
The people who watch the video?
Oh, I have something to tell you. I've always counted with his support in my cancer, and he's always with me when I need him. He's so sweet. I love him very much. He always tells me what I need to hear. He's a great boy. I love you. So that's him, my Gonza. I love him very much.
Just know that you will definitely be remembered by everyone in years to years to come. And I'm not saying this to sound wrong. I hope you stay here for years with us, but you will be remembered even 100 years later. Trust me, I will make sure that this video one day makes it out there so that you are remembered. So basically, so to see if we can motivate people to show them that if you could do it, many other people can do it. And this was also an awareness video, but mainly this video was for you, Grandma. But I also do want to show people how strong of a person is out there in the world like you. So to see if we can give some people strength and faith. You are a walking miracle. And I hope people see you as an example, because you really are. You're my example. You're one of my biggest parts about my heart. You're one of the biggest parts about my life. And that's how it will always be, and it will never change. Keep on fighting for it, Grandma. Literally, you impressed me so much, you have no idea. You have literally blown my mind away. And I mean that beyond words. You are my hero. I love you.